Alright, so don't worry, this whole video isn't going to be a voiceover, it's just this first little warm-up section of the video. But over the years, I've learned the importance of a good warm-up and actually taking your time before getting onto the bench. And so I always start by doing like 15 reps of a really light weight on each lat, of course. But it's important to get a back pump because it's going to give us a solid foundation to bench off. I'll explain more in a little bit. And I'll go over and I'll do the exact same thing with tricep extensions. Again, a really light weight, like 15 reps, just to promote blood flow because that's gonna help us out at lockout. It's important to not be tender, not be stiff going into this movement. Then I'll take a resistance band and do some band work just to get a full, nice stretch of the shoulder, get it open and ready to push some heavy weight. I'll go in front, I'll go behind, and I'll usually do about 8 repetitions, if you want to call it that. And lastly, I'll take like a 5-pound, sometimes 10-pound weight, and I'll just do some shoulder rotational work. And I put a lot of emphasis on the external rotation as well, like I'm doing here, just because it's helped a lot with my shoulder pain recently.
All right, so for me, one of the biggest things that's helped my bench is actually taking the time to warm up. When I was like 16, 17 years old, I could come in, go straight to my working set and be fine. And I don't want to call myself old, but the older you get in general, you have to actually start taking warm-ups seriously, especially if you want to increase your bench, because eventually your shoulders are going to start aching, your triceps are going to start hurting, and it's not fun benching when everything hurts. It's not fun doing any compound lift when any part of your body hurts. So that warm-up routine I did right there, that's like the bare minimum. If you still feel stiff, go ahead and do more. Take your time warming up. It helps a lot, especially getting blood flow into your lats and your triceps, because that's going to help with your lockout. Back pumped up is going to help give you a good foundation to bench off of. It sounds weird, but if you have a thick back, you have more to work with in terms of pressing. That's why it's nice to bench on a fat pad. If you don't have a fat pad at your gym, at least get a back pump beforehand so you have a solid foundation to bench off. Alright, so now that I'm actually warming up with weight, this brings me to my second tip. Do your best to make every single warm-up rep look the same. I know a lot of you guys want to disregard it and get to your top set as fast as possible, but once again, all good things take time. So take your time on warm-ups, make every rep look the same, make it look flawless, make it look effortless, and that'll set you up for success when it finally comes to your top set, because your body will be so primed with that exact movement, but you have no issue replicating that exact same form. Another thing to keep in mind is the bar path when you're benching. It isn't directly vertical going up and down, but if anything, it's more so down at an angle, and then you want to bring it back in up like that. It shouldn't be directly up and down. You should bring it down at an angle to your chest and then explode back up like that. Alright, so the next tip I have for you guys is doing paused benches or tempo benches. I'm doing paused benches because I'm on prep for my first powerlifting meet, but it's just something that's gonna help overall, like even if you're just trying to get your bench up in general, because pausing teaches you control, teaches you how to be patient, it teaches you to slow down the eccentric so that you're not exploding right off of your chest. You can obviously do more with your touch and go bench and with your ass off when you're cheating, but unfortunately that doesn't slide in comp. So training to a higher standard is ultimately gonna benefit you in the long run. Another thing, you see a lot of these influencers talking about hypertrophy work, at least, saying go to failure, or at least they're up short of failure. Now, in terms of powerlifting, as much as I would love that to be true, because it's fun as fuck to go heavy, don't get me wrong. If you're doing that week in, week out, your central nervous system is gonna poop out after a while. I've learned the hard way, that's how I've gotten injured, and again, like I said, it'd be awesome if that was true, because I have the work ethic to do so. But we use a term called building momentum in terms of powerlifting. Like last week I did 265 for a single because it was week one. Today was 280. And even though these are easy singles, this first 2-3 weeks, week four is where it starts to get heavy, where it starts to get fun. You can get a little more hyped up for your lifts. But we use the term building momentum because at the start of your program, you're not gonna be going heavy. You slowly build up over the course of a few weeks to prime your body, and then you back down to give it a little break. Give your central nervous system a deload, because if you're training balls to the walls every single session, you're going to poop out so quick, and I promise you, that's how you get injured. So as much as it sucks to drop your ego and actually train within, like, you know, a designated RPE range, if you want to get strong and become great, it's something you have to do. Tip I have for you guys while we're actually on the bench before I go over to some secondary movements is bench frequency. Now there are powerlifters who benefit from benching upwards of 4, even 5 times a week. Personally, I couldn't do that. I'm not at that level yet. I don't know if I ever will. But even just benching 3 times a week instead of 2, or if you're benching once a week, 2 times a week, increasing the frequency to at least one more session than you're already doing can actually benefit you a lot if you know how to spread out your volume and manage fatigue. So for example, primary deadlift is Monday, then after I do secondary bench, where I'll do ascending sets. 2 of the 3 sets are super light because you're ascending. You're starting off with weight you would do normally when you're warming up. And then I work up to 1 top set, and that's the most I do for that day. It's not that heavy. It's usually pretty easy within like RPE 6 or 7. And one little thing, if you don't know what RPE is, it's rate of perceived exhaustion, and it ties in with reps in reserve. So if something's RPE 6, that means you could have done 4 more reps by the time you're done. RPE 7, 3 left, RPE 8, 2 left, and so on. So it's a really helpful measurement that you can use to gauge your strength training. But then I have my primary bench day, which is the day where I work up in the single. This is where the real strength's built, with the 3 sets of 6 with 235. And then Saturday is my tertiary or secondary bench day. And so I do close grip on those days. Again, anything that's really just gonna help your bench in any significant way, we'll be working on, like, you know, different parts of the muscle you normally wouldn't work on in the main primary movement, but it'll all tie in to help overall build a big bench. All right, so the next tip is doing movements outside of your compound lifts or bench that are gonna actually benefit you. Now, time and time again, you hear people raving about incline dumbbell bench. Oh, it's the best chest movement. And, you know, as annoying as it is to hear that same overrated statement, it happens to be true. So if you want to build a big bench, it's important to actually, you know, work your upper chest. Because to be honest, if I weren't powerlifting, I probably wouldn't flat bench at all. If your goal is hypertrophy, it's low-key as shit movement unless you're a beginner. Doing incline bench is going to help strengthen your upper chest, which overall is going to strengthen your chest as a whole. So if you can get strong with dumbbells, that'll totally correlate to barbell. Because think about it. On barbell, you're stuck with one range of movement, down and up. But with dumbbell, you have that whole range of motion. You go out to the side, to go out here, to go blah, blah, blah. You get the point. So if you can actually, like, strengthen your balancing muscles and get pretty heavy with that, then when you go back to barbell, it's going to be a piece of cake. I've heard success stories of people who have given up flat benching for like half a year. They only did dumbbell. They come back, boom, bench is way stronger. So now tie that to actually frequently bench pressing, you're going to be on top.
And so make sure you're training for cheeks, man. We are everyone training on the heat, man.
Do a heavy dumbbell row. It's gonna be chest supported, so now I'm gonna lay on my stomach or on my chest on that bench. Building a big back is one of them, because like I talked about when you were warming up, you wanna get blood flow in your back, build a big foundation. Building a turtle shell back, it's gonna benefit you in all aspects of life. Not only is back, you know, everyone's favorite muscle group, the most aesthetic one. I'm not biased at all, it's not like it's my best body part. But you wanna build a big back so that it'll aid in your bench press, so you have more of a foundation to work with. Gave me a range of 465 to 475. Coach, I know in the notes he said 470, be smart, but I love those opportunities to go for heavy weight when I have the chance. And I'm not gonna lie, I feel really good right now. Well, that's a shame. Some of the things are, what's it, stitching. Messed up. But, oh shit. I got like, I think it's 353 on right now. Two reds and a blue. I'll put the math up on the screen, but I'm gonna take this for one, maybe two warm-up reps. That's how I feel. So as you saw, 470, it was 474, the way the kilos worked out. I've never squatted on kilos before, let alone a rack like that. It's really weird not like looking at myself in a mirror, but it felt good. Overall, it felt good. I kind of went into it with low confidence because the 440 I did before that didn't move too hot and it was too low on my back, so it felt unstable. So I'm Yappatron right now. But anyways, overall, I'm happy with the session. 474 for a double. Three reds or 375 for three sets of six back downs.